There can be many forms of bradycardia. Commonly seen blocks may include sinus bradycardia and multiple heart blocks, including complete third-degree heart block. It's vital to remember that if the bradycardia, regardless of the underlying reason, is causing the patient to display symptoms related to that bradycardia, it should be treated. So now let's take a look at the ECG. And first we start with the rhythm. Is the rhythm regular or irregular? In this case, it's regular. What is the rate? The rhythm and rate is less than 60 beats per minute. Is the rate normal, fast, or slow? The rate is slow. So next we evaluate the P waves. Are they present? And in this case, yes. We then say, do they occur regularly? And the answer is yes to that as well. Is there one P wave for each QRS complex? Yes, there is one P wave for each QRS complex. Are the P waves smooth, rounded, and upright? Yes, they are smooth and they're rounded as well as being upright. And do all P waves have similar shapes? The answer to that is yes. So now we want to know what the PR interval is for this ECG. The PR interval is normal. It's less than 0.20 seconds. Is the PR interval constant? The answer is yes. So now we move on to the QRS complex of the ECG. Is the QRS interval less than 0.09 seconds? Yes, the QRS interval is less than 0.09 seconds. Is it wide or narrow? And in this case, the QRS is narrow. Are the QRS complexes similar in appearance? Yes, we can see that each one looks similar. So our cardiac interpretation based on this ECG finding is that this patient is in sinus bradycardia. Proper oxygenation and ventilation are crucial for a child to increase the heart rate. For a bradycardic child with a pulse rate less than 60 and signs of poor perfusion, despite oxygen and ventilation, we must start compressions with CPR right away.